Hello, my perfume lovers, addicts, fanáticas del perfume como yo. Welcome back to another video. And this video is about office-friendly fragrances that you can wear to the office. I think I just repeated the same thing, but these are perfumes that will not be offensive. Usually, I like the long, the strong, the bold, the gourmand, the floral, and all of that. But these are softer, okay? They are more crowd pleasing. I believe that, in my opinion, for the office, usually more designer fragrances are better to fit the atmosphere of the office, because they are more you know, pretty type of fragrances, and they won't bother anyone, you know, as long as you don't spray too much. I spray however much I want. So probably a lot of these fragrances, you will see that I don't talk about them that much, but it's because I wear whatever I want to the office. The only thing that I don't wear, or I'm more mindful of certain people that will be there on certain days, is oud, because oud is something that some people don't like and it might bother them. So I try to not bother people, but you know, sometimes I can't help myself and I wear it anyway. So they're gonna have to forgive me for that. So anyways, let me just get into, I have 10 here. I cheated on two, but you'll see in a second why. So here we go. Okay, so the first one that I have here is Lancôme La Vie est Belle en Rose. So this is their version, a flanker that has rose, but it's a really pretty scent. It's not too strong or anything. It's not, I think it's an EDT. Yeah, it's an EDT. So it doesn't last that long. It's soft and it's very pretty. So this is just, I'm gonna spray. This is just so pretty and is perfect for the office. So how did I cheat? Because I chose this one in the same category as one. So two, this one is La Vie est Belle Eclat. So this one is an orange blossom one. It's also very classy orange blossom. I feel it's like a kind of classy note. So this one would be good for the office too. This one does last longer than this one. Okay, that's that. The next one I have is Tiffany & Co. Tiffany & Co, just the original. This is very classy. So this is just perfect for the office. Okay, I'm gonna spray. The sprayer is very nice. You see, it's very classy, elegant, okay? That's the vibe that this gives. Now, in the same category as that, I have Tiffany & Co and Gold. So it's the flanker of this one, but it has rose, okay? So it has, oh, look here, the nose. It has blackcurrant, blue rose, and bread. So this one is just, you know, it's, I like this one better. It's kind of like that fresh, clean rose. Very pretty, very pretty. So I prefer this one, but they're both very classy, perfect for the office, okay? Next one. Next one I have is Coach. This is the original. It's not the flanker or anything. So I never realized how much I used, because I haven't used this in forever, but it seems like when I used it, I went really hard, because I barely have any in there, even though this is a 1 ounce bottle. Okay, so this is a nice classy one. It has suede, it has those florals. Might have some, a little bit of fruitiness in there with the raspberry. It's very nice, very perfect for the office, okay? The next one I'm going to mention is by Al Haramain. This is Junoon Rose, Junoon Noir, okay? Junoon Noir, and this one is the dupe for Dama Bianca by Georgia. So this one is a very pretty, it's like vanilla, but it has iris, it's powdery, it's just a very pretty, classy, beautiful. This is beautiful and it's light, but it does last pretty long. So, you know, it's perfect. You know, you for the office, you want something that is gonna, you know, you're gonna smell yourself, but you don't wanna like, you know, make anybody annoyed or anything like that. Or you can, you know, if you wanna annoy somebody, go ahead. And the next one I have is L'Interdit by Givenchy. So this one I had mentioned in a previous video that I was thinking about decluttering it, but I just say that, but I'm not going to actually declutter it because I know that I will regret it and I will want to wear it. This is a super classy tuberose. It has that bubblegummy tuberose. Let me spray this, but like a classy, very classy bubblegummy tuberose, okay? So this is perfect for the office, perfect. Okay, the next one I have here is Narciso, and this is the original Narciso. You know, I have all of the cubes. There's the Narciso Poudre, the Ombre, and I forgot the other one, the red one, that one. But this one is, I feel like, perfect for the office. It has great longevity. I give you that, and it's just powdery, okay? It has rose and I think gardenia, so it's not for everyone, but it's just so pretty, very powdery and pretty, okay? There's that one. It might have a little bit of that kind of makeup vibe in a way. Anyways, so the next one I have here, this is a more... It is for the office, but it can also be sexy. So this is Luxury Rouge, and this is the imitation of Rouge Malachite, Malachite by Armani Privé. And this one is a beautiful tuberose. It is creamy, okay? This is beautiful, and it has good longevity. This is very affordable too. I may or may not have bought the other one, the green one. Oh my gosh, this is freaking beautiful. This is beautiful. This is more my territory. The other ones are nice and pretty. This starts getting like more into my type of thing. But anyways, the office, okay? The next one I have here is a very pretty one, Armani Si Fiori. Unfortunately, discontinued. It's a beautiful, creamy, creamy, powdery, neroli and rose, is it? I forgot what's the floral on here. Oh, it's so good. This is such a pretty princessy type of perfume, but since it's light and powdery and creamy, it's just such a pretty fragrance. It's perfect for the office, okay? The next one I have is a celebrity, J.Lo. This is J.Lo Glow, the original. This one is a, like I had said before, is I feel like it's a soapy rose. And it's just so appropriate for the office. And it has good longevity to be such an, like $20. I love it. I love it. This is a old school. This is throwback. This has been around for a long time. Even when I was a teenager and everything. And this was, I remember, really nice. I'm starting to irritate because I've sprayed like a lot of fragrance. Okay. The last one I have here is Chloe Nomad. This one, I always forget to use it, but I know that this is perfect for the office, okay? It has things that make it a little bit different. It has that moss. A lot of these have powdery type of qualities. They have musk and of course, a little floral in there. This one has suede and everything. So they all have something classy about them. This is very different. This is very different, but it's nice. Okay, I need to use it because look at that. It's way too full, right? I forget. I have a lot. So
Everyone, I forgot to mention that Michael Kors and Marc Jacobs fragrances are perfect for the office too, okay?
Thank you for watching this video and let me know what you think is appropriate for the office. And of course, wear what you want to wear. You know, we try to like not offend everyone and, you know, people with their allergies and stuff, but sometimes, you know, we just got to do it. We just gotta do it because we gotta feel good about our fragrance. Sorry. I'm just kidding. Am I? Thank you everyone for watching. Until next time. Bye.